Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the athletes for the men's 50 freestyle Olympic final.
The splash and dash 50 meter freestyle. Those are the starters who've made it all the way through from an enormous number of heats this morning. The first to come out is Tandy from South Africa. 25 years old, slipped into this in eighth position.
Simonas Belish is in lane number one. He's from Lithuania. He's 22 years of age. In the 100 freestyle, he came 30th. He didn't get past the heat process. I love it. What a home ground advantage, a home crowd advantage for Bruno Frattis. He's coached by Brett Hawke at the Auburn University. Brett Hawke coached Cesar Cielo to Olympic gold. Can he do it again?
The noise still resounding as the next man comes out, Ben Proud of Great Britain.
He'll be the only man in this final that stands upright before the take your marks. Everybody else hangs down. You'll see his red cap pop up.
The USA have not won this since 2004. And they have two chances with this man, first of all, Nathan Adrian. He's a national record holder. And the other chance comes in the form of the 35-year-old Anthony Irvin.
Evergreen, wouldn't it be a remarkable story? He won this in 2000, then went to the Olympic Games in 2012 and came back again now in 2016. Govorov in lane number five from the Ukraine. Made the final of this 53 at the World Championships, has a PB of 21.46. But the man that has the fastest personal best time in the field is this man, Florent Manadou. He is looking to defend his Olympic crown from London 2012.
So they come from Lithuania, Great Britain, USA, France, Ukraine, Brazil, and South Africa. Two from the USA. It may take some while to calm them. Bruno Frattis is a real chance here. He swims in lane seven.
Well, if Manadou can win this and get a second gold medal, he'll join the great Alexander Popov, who won it in 92 and 96, and also Gary Hall Jr., who won it a couple of times.
Once he shared it with Anthony Irvin. Whoa.
Wow.
You've commented on the red marks on him over his tattoos. He can't help but be affected by this noise.
Well, they will really insist, particularly the men's 50 meters freestyle, because they are just so,
Listen to that.
But the thing is that for the respect of the two Brazilian athletes in here as well, they need to be quiet so that they get a fair start as well. Lots of sympathetic shushes in the audience.
They go through their personal rituals. The final of the 50 freestyle. The noise is deafening. Proud gets out in lane two. Tandy of South Africa. They come with 10 to go. Manadou and Irvin. 16 years on, he wins the gold again. 16 years later, he wins the gold again.
What a story. Anthony Irvin takes it in a 21-4-0. The margin was 1/100th of a second. Heartbreaking for Florent Manadou. He gets the silver. It's not what he wanted. He wanted the gold, and he missed it by 1/100th of a second. He's been a leader on this US team. He lost his way for a little bit. Swimming helped him find himself again. He announced his retirement in 2003 at 22, and we are so glad 13 years later he is here, showing that you don't need to be a teenager to win an Olympic Games gold medal. 35 years of age, the whitewash. He was clearly in front of Manadou. Manadou came back better than him in the last 15 metres. But Irvin had done enough on the start and the first 25 metres to be able to hold on.
Like a wonderful red wine, he gets better and better with age. Anthony Irvin, at 35 years of age, one of only a handful of individuals in their 30s who has won an Olympic gold medal, and the oldest. 21.4. That's a personal best for him. Manadou, the defender, is the silver medalist. And Nathan Adrian gives the USA the bronze as well.
Cerimônia de premiação dos 50 livre masculino dos Jogos Olímpicos Rio 2016. Por gentileza,
for the second time in his life, this man stands behind the highest part of the podium here, not here, but at an Olympic Games.
Nathan Adrian.
So he's won a pair of bronzes, or a pair of bronze medals, 50 free that we see now, but he won bronze in the 100 free as well.
United States adding to the collection for their country, a bronze medal.
This is the FINA Bureau member for Brazil. So again, they're probably thinking that potentially Bruno Fratus, where did he finish? Equal six, he went 21.79.
Florent Manadou, he was attempting to return with another gold medal to achieve what he did 4 years ago. He'd slipped off the pace a wee bit after London, but he stormed back with some great times. Fastest time in the year of the year, 21.32. He had every chance to recapture the gold medal. Instead, he was touched out. And now for France, has the silver medal around his neck. The story will go on and on, won't it?
It's just incredible. He returned to the US national team at the London 2012 Olympic Games after retiring in 2003 after the World Championships. And here he is all these years later. He won in 2000 and he wins again, and he sold his medal for charity for UNICEF, so now he has another gold medal.
Fate.
Karma.
Yeah.
He's not the tallest of the medalists either. So for those of you out there that think that you need to be the tallest to win the race, you don't.